After their hike of the Inca Trail in 2018, of Mount Fuji in 2019, the Fantastic Four meet again for a short urban walk in Hong Kong while reminiscing on their March 2020 adventures in Jordan.
Our goal is always to do an epic hike every year, and New Zealand is always on top of our list, and we were going to go for it. And then when I was doing research, I found out about this Jordan Trail, which actually officially opened in 2017. And then of course the romance of Indiana Jones and Petra, the Valley of the Moon, you know, that always, you know, had drawn me. So we put it on our list as well. And eventually we chose the Jordan Trail because we decided we wanted to spend more time in New Zealand. After we decided on Jordan, I know I needed to find an outfit that can make sure that we can do it safely, because most of the trails are unmarked. And the second criteria is we need people to take care of us so we can do this as comfortably as possible.
Dan, once May said, okay, I suggest experience Jordan, you just jumped in.
I have no friends, so basically, I just follow along. No, just because I wanted to see Jordan. And given that we have done a few epic hikes, it's going to be a great addition to what we've started. Basically, we're looking for the flight that is reasonably priced and has the best scheduling. And then May found the deal with Etihad, and we just worked with it.
We didn't want to go to Dubai again, because we've been to Dubai. And Etihad flies to Abu Dhabi, which we haven't been.
Just before we left, Royal Jordanian and Qatar Airlines canceled all Hong Kong flights, and all guests at some of the hotels in Abu Dhabi got quarantined.
You have chosen wisely.
And as we were getting closer to the date of departure, you know, things started to happen. Like right. In Iran first, you know, when there was the Turkish planes shot down, and we were all wondering what was going to happen there.
Yeah, we're concerned about the safety of the Middle East and any planes that's flying through it.
Yeah, so I messaged Waisa at Experience Jordan right away just to see what she thinks, and she reassured us that it's still safe. Jordan hasn't issued any travel warning.
And they ask us for passports, right? May and I send our Canadian passports, and Rosanna and Dan send their Hong Kong passports, right? So the rationale there was that the Hong Kong passports don't need a visa for Jordan, correct?
Correct.
But then I thought it'd be safer if we all travel with the Canadian passport.
So you asked Raisa to change the passports. And since the Amman Airport has pre-approved visa service for tourists to avoid crowding at customs, the fact that we were registered with Canadian passports removed any concerns about being stopped at the border, as Jordan had closed its borders to Chinese visitors.
As we get near February, I think the most concerns is really is the coronavirus. So what we worried about the most is whether there will be a shutdown in Hong Kong where nobody can fly out or in. But then we weren't really that impacted until your flight got canceled. Instead of having flying, 7 days a week, they canceled two of them. That was the first cancellation. But then just before we fly out, like a couple days before, they canceled our flight.
They canceled all our flights.
Yeah, they canceled that second flight. And that's when we had to reroute, and then we were able to get it through Bangkok. And in fact, it was Rosanna who discovered that our flight was canceled.
She sent a message at like 11 p.m. She sent it to the group, and that's how we found out. And then I called Etihad right away to figure it out.
Yeah, but when you called, they didn't offer you the sole option.
Which was good, because if they had given me the option like they did for you to fly through Korea, I might have taken Korea because it has a shorter layover, but then it ended up Korea eventually closed the border.
Yes, they did.
Right? Yeah. So we wouldn't be able to go.
So we were all a bit concerned about the trip, right?
Usually before a trip, you know, you anticipate, you're excited, but just so many uncertainties.
And then it kept going with more travel bans, a second death in Hong Kong, and even freaking sandstorms. But there were still less than a handful of cases in Hong Kong, Abu Dhabi, and Jordan, so we could not fathom why our trip would be cancelled. And finally, it was Rosanna and Dan's departure date. Off to Dubai via Abu Dhabi.
It's a very, very beautiful city and very modern. It is very widespread. It's not made for pedestrians. There's a lot of barriers and freeway and highway and overpasses in between that is made for cars. So even if it's like only a 5 minutes walk, you still need to take a taxi. But it's very beautiful.
The day after, it's May and I's turn to fly out. We get to the airport and the airline clerk refuses to issue our boarding passes.
Yeah, they were arguing with us saying that, oh, you need a visa for UAE.
It took us 20 minutes to sort this out. Then off we were.
Whee! Once we took off to Bangkok, I didn't think anything would happen because at that point, Thailand is still okay. So I knew we would at least get to Abu Dhabi.
At the Abu Dhabi airport waiting for our flight, we saw a few Emiratis checking in with their Falcons. We were told they only are allowed in business class, but they were actually right behind us in economy.
So the day before our hike, we were in Amman. This is our second day in Amman. And Mahmoud came.
Great hair.
And that's our first day of the tour.
And Dan had a major bromance with Mahmoud.
Yes. That was the best part of Jordan. We were able to see in the morning the Citadel, the amphitheater. That was quite nice. Then we went to lunch and then it downpoured. And so we didn't do the city walk. And then he dropped us off. We decided to go to the mall because we need to get some money. And so so we walked to the mall and we were able to get some nice coffee at Dimitri's. And then we also got our money. And then we decided the mall was kind of boring. So we left, went back to our hotel, and then we went to dinner.
Oh, the cat.
The cat?
In the cafe. Our first meal, we met this cat.
So that's what you remember of Amman? That's a cat?
I don't know. I mean, the street art was really nice and there was a good vibe in the city.
I thought the food was quite good.
The food was excellent.
All of a sudden we got this email.
Oh yeah, that's right. We got that email saying our flight to Hong Kong from Bangkok was canceled.
Yes, so we tried to check with the local ETN agents, but the offices had just closed for the day.
And then we decided not to do anything in Abu Dhabi. So then we waited until Amman, and then we started calling them at the hotel. And then it was a bit confusion. Finally, we realized the way that the email worded, it seemed like we got rebooked back on the same flight.
Yeah, I remember the agent from ETN said he was going to send confirmation emails to the four of us. We waited and we never received them. His manager said to wait a few more days for the final email confirmation.
So we just went with that, hoping that
we have a flight back to Hong Kong.
Yeah. I think the first view of Dana Reserve, that was really beautiful. Just stepping out of that village, you didn't expect that it is actually a big canyon sort of like way below you. So I think that was a very nice introduction to the hike.
Well, me going in, I mean, before May showed me the pictures way back with the mountains and stuff, I was a little bit apprehensive about going into a hike that would be like desert,
yes.
Flat,
yes.
Nothing, well, something to see, but the same over 5 days.
Yes.
And
yes.
I think it turned out not to be that at all.
No, right? It was more diverse.
I told you we'll be like walking through like four ecosystems.
Yeah, of deserts.
No, we just have blind faith. And your ability
and
to organize.
You tell us that it's four ecosystems. Yeah, I saw that and I read that, but I'm just still thinking that it's desert and it's loose rocks and brown, and that's what I expected.